Greetings one, greetings all. Haven't been on in a while except for that lighter pick or that lighter tip that I just did. Really haven't had much pipe related new going on. Down here in the studio tonight doing some stuff on a computer. But I did have some new pipe stuff to go over with you. My smoking buddy, Kyle, that I think a lot of you know about, the big cigar guy, he dropped off some presents. One of them was this tin of Dunhill Elizabeth... Come on, I could say this 42 times in one day, and now I can't say it. Elizabethan mixture. There we go. Boy, tripped me up. A new tin of this. It's Virginia's, which I really love. It's one of my favorites. A rich flavored blend of fine and dark Virginia tobaccos with a touch of Louisiana Perique. So it's a vapor. And I've had a couple bowls of it, and I really like it. The Perique is not real strong and real peppery like a lot of the vapor blends are. I haven't had much luck with Dunhill blends, the new Dunhill blends, because a lot of them give me tongue bite and they seem to have a real high nicotine content that even me, I mean, I smoke 10 plus bowls a day. Even I can't handle the nicotine on some of their blends. I think my favorite new Dunhill blend right now would be Dunhill Flake. Hands down is my favorite of all they make. But this, I never even considered trying it before. Elizabethan mixture. I'm really impressed with it. I like it. It's probably going to show up in the rotation. And I've got quite the rotation now. My all-time everyday go-to blend that I smoke all day in the truck when I'm working is still Cornell and Deal's Bayou Morning. It's a vapor as well. I just love that stuff. And my all-time favorite aromatic is Cornell and Deal's Autumn Evening. Hands down, I've loved that for years. It's, to this day, it's still my favorite. In my Weber here, I have Bio Morning. That's what I'm smoking right now. But anyway, so he gave me a tin of that, and then he gave me a baggie of what he calls Kyle's Virginia Slaw. I love it. Must be a lot of McClellans in here, because it has that characteristic McClellan's Virginia ketchup smell. And I really like that. I enjoy that a lot. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to take it out of this bag right now, the Ziploc bag, and I'm going to put it in a tin so that it doesn't lose its potency. The plastic bag will allow some of the flavor and some of the tin note or bag note to become weakened over time. But this has a lot of dark. This is his own mix. I don't know what's in it, but it has a lot of red stoved Virginia in it. Oh, it's heaven. And that too is a very good smoking blend. Kyle's Virginia Slaw. He hit one out of the park with that. The big news is this. This is my first pipe that I carved. I'm gonna pick you up and take you under a light so you can see this. Turn the camera around so you can actually see it a little better, so I can see what I'm doing. three-quarter inch bowl. I made it for my fly fishing buddy that I steelhead fish with. He's gotten into pipe smoking as well. So I carved a fly on the side of there, on each side. Did some rustication on it. And I modeled it after that field stub that I have. It's longer than the field stub. The bit is a lot longer than I would like. I'd like to shorten it up. What I should have done was cut the shank down, and that would have shortened this up significantly so it fits in the pocket better. But that's my first pipe. And I bought one of those kits, one of those Ebotions or whatever they're called, the kits that you can get from Four Noggins or whatever. And I just went to town with the bandsaw and the drum sander and everything and made that shape. And it's got a nice wide saddle bit on it. The only thing I screwed up is I did a little sanding on the shank here. And I actually, you know, they had it matched up perfectly, the diameter of the bit and the shank. And when I hit it with the sander, obviously I made it smaller. So now there's a little bit of a lip there. I don't like that, but I'll know next time not to even just touch this area with the sander at all. But anyway, he's going to really like that. So that's pretty cool. So anyway, other than that, nothing new in the pipe world. I've just been buying tobacco by the pound like I always do. Virginia blends and vapors and stuff like that. Nothing else new to report, but I just wanted to show that off and chime in and say hi and a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to everybody. And if any of you fly fishing guys out there, I know backwoods pipe and stuff like that, there might be one of these in your future as well. I got a couple of people in mind that I wouldn't mind making a nice little pocket pipe. What I'll do is, since this shank is so long, this bit is so long, is I'll cut this shank down in half. I'll try to make the pipe the same rustication, the same nice glossy finish on it and everything like that. And I didn't use traditional pipe making techniques with this pipe, okay? I did it my way, and so far it's working. I varnished it with Minwax red mahogany varnish, and then I clear coated it with Spar marine urethane. And I've done that with some of my other pipes, and it gives it a real glossy finish. You don't have to get the gloss with the wax. You use the urethane to do that. And it smells like varnish for a couple of days, or until you smoke a couple of bowls through it. But it retains its gloss. You can put wax on there if you want and get the shine back. I've had good luck. It doesn't blister up when it gets hot. I've had really good luck. There's been a couple of old, this Savinelli. When I got this Savinelli, it was just dull and it had been unrestored and just awful. So I sanded it. I took all the old stain off. I don't remember how I did that. I think I did that by accident. Oh, I washed it with soap, dish soap, and it took the stain right off of it. So then I was left with raw briar. So then I just hit it with the shellac, and it brought the natural color of the briar out and this awesome gloss. Did that with that one, and then this other Savinelli, same thing. Looked like crap when I got it. Clear coated it with the Spar urethane, and it's just gorgeous. So that method really works well for me. I'm going to keep doing that. There's a couple people out there, special people out there in the YouTube world that might find one of those in their mailbox someday. So that's all I got. Gotta go, stuff to do, people to talk to. So until next time, we'll catch all of you on the flip side.